Completely. I think what was so lovely about it is I could come back, sort of briefly say hello to the character again, and not shoulder that same responsibility. You know, for me, it felt more like a family reunion than it felt like coming back and playing a character. Because the character and the little bit that I have, I think also what's so lovely about it is that it's a part of the character that we didn't get a chance to see a lot of in The Lord of the Rings. Because in The Lord of the Rings, once the journey starts, the burden that that character has to hold gets more and more intense throughout the films. And we don't get to see the innocent Frodo as much. So it was lovely to come back and sort of play the youthful, you know, the hobbit that is unaware of the future that is in front of him. And yes, indeed, not to have to, you know, encapsulate the entire character arc. It was lovely to just come in briefly. It was incredible to go back to Hobbiton. You know, what hit me is that I had turned 19 the first time that we shot in Hobbiton in 2000. And I was 30 last year when I was back in Hobbiton again. It was magical. You know, I think what was so extraordinary about that particular location, I think in some ways above all of them on the Rings, was how real it was. It felt like a real place. And this time around, they actually rebuilt with permanent materials, so that when, you know, from now on, people can go and visit the location exactly as it was in the film. So it was really, it was quite beautiful. It brought back so many memories, just walking around and seeing the hobbit holes. It was totally transportive. It was quite extraordinary. Well, I think Frodo was born with a sense of interest in adventure. And I think part of that is because of the fact that Bilbo raised him. So I think Bilbo raised him with an interest in the outside world, which is not typical to hobbits. Hobbits aren't supposed to be interested in the world outside of Hobbiton. Because it's uncomfortable and it's potentially dangerous, and they like the comfort of home and knowing where everything is and that they're safe and insulated. And that's ultimately what Bilbo starts as, and it's kind of lovely to see the beginning in this film, understanding that Bilbo's roots were actually much more hobbity than he ultimately became. He was a character that had no interest in adventures or meeting elves or dragons or any of those things. It was entirely uncomfortable to him. But obviously, over the course of that journey, he finds a lust for adventure and travel and instills those things, I think, upon Frodo. So their differences are that I think Frodo was kind of born with an interest, whereas Bilbo had to discover that interest. But I think the characters that you meet in The Lord of the Rings, that Bilbo of that time, the 111th-year-old Bilbo and Frodo, are actually quite similar. They share a sort of common interest in the outside world, and a lot of that, I think, came from Bilbo onto Frodo. Martin's incredible. I remember hearing that Martin was potentially going to be cast to play Bilbo, and I couldn't imagine anyone more perfectly suited for the character. I'm a fan of Martin's work, and I have been for years as an actor. I think he's a brilliant dramatic actor, but also a brilliant comedic actor. I think he encapsulates all the things that make Bilbo who he is. I think he's a perfect follow-up to Ian Holm. Ian's performance was so iconic in the way that he embodied the character. And I think all of the things that make Bilbo who he is are sort of attributes that come very naturally to Martin. And after seeing the film twice now, he's extraordinary. you know, he's the heart of the film. He is sort of our, he's the human element to a certain degree. He's the audience because everything is happening to him along this sort of journey and on this adventure. He's wonderful. It's a really delightful, heartfelt performance, and I can't wait to see the other two films to see where it goes and to see how he changes. It was incredible. I mean, Pete, I mean, I feel fortunate to have had those experiences making Lord of the Rings, because Pete feels like family now. Going back to New Zealand feels like going home. So getting a chance to work with Pete again as a director was a treat. You know, in a lot of ways, it felt like no time had passed. Being on set and sort of getting direction from him was so transportive. I felt like, in some ways, it was only yesterday that we were doing scenes from Lord of the Rings. I remember going to Bag End for the first time on this and shooting on the Bag End set and looking around and kind of having that feeling of time travel. Like, and suddenly we're here again. It was really extraordinary. And Pete this time around was, I don't think I've ever seen him so relaxed and so at ease and almost jovial. You know, those are elements that I know of him. And I'd certainly seen that before. But I think, you know, the intensity of the Rings experience was all-encompassing, I think, for all of us, you know. And for him as a director, his responsibility was so intense. You know, it was all unpaved ground. A lot of what we were trying to accomplish had never been accomplished before. And I think he really shouldered the stress and that sense of responsibility. And I think this time around, so much of Middle Earth and what we had done had been established. So I think it was an easier experience for him. And it was delightful to see. It was lovely to come to set and to see him so relaxed. And he's even said it's the most fun he's had making a film ever, which is really, really wonderful. So it was great to come back and to feel that similar sense of just sort of joviality and fun. It was great. I think the film's incredible. I think what I feel so grateful to be included, obviously, but also to have the ability to be objective. Obviously, with the first three Lord of the Rings films, you know, all of us were in the films, you know, in a very significant way, and you know, Frodo's journey was a significant element of those films. This time around, I was barely there for shooting. You know, they shot for 18 months and I was there for a month. I shot 3 days in New Zealand. So I actually was able to look at the movie from an objective perspective because I wasn't there for most of it. And that was so much fun. I didn't get that same experience on Rings because it was tied to so much of our experience collectively. So this time around, you know, it was just a pure joy and I got to see it sort of as a fan. The film is incredible. You know, it's I think the technology has certainly moved forward. The work that Weta Digital have done is extraordinary. Peter as a director, you know, there's a confidence, there are flourishes within the context of the film that are breathtaking and extraordinary. And it's he's made a very transportive, immersive film. And I think the 48 frames to a certain degree helps with that in the 3D. But the storytelling is also extremely immersive. It's an amazing experience. You really feel like you've kind of gone through something at the end of the film. And it leaves you with a very intense yearning for the next film. You want to see where it's going to go. It's very much a kind of beginning of the journey sort of film. Yet a lot happens. It's kind of relentless. It's you know, once they leave Hobbiton, it sort of doesn't stop. It's one incredible thing happens to them after another. It leaves you sort of exhausted and in a really good way. It's awesome.